presentation deals with transactional internet service composition. It concerns research projects, but don't be afraid, I will try to be pedagogic. So this is the outline of the presentation. In the first two slides, I will try to present you the research team. Then I will give you a simple view of the project. And after, I will present you the hypothesis we are, which concerns what kind of services we manage. And okay, thank you. So what kind of services we manage and how they are described and organized. Then I will present you our approach and give you some ideas of our future research. So the team concerns researchers from LAMSAD of the Dauphine, Paris Dauphine University, not so far from there, in the west of Paris. The LAMSAD is a laboratoire d'analyse et modélisation d'aide à la décision. It's well known for operational research and multi-criteria decision aid research project. Inside this laboratory, there is a small team working on massive data, and inside this team, there is a smaller team working on services. So this is the team which has initiated the project a few years ago. So the boss is Martha Rico. She is professor at Nanterre and researcher at the LAMSAD. And Joyce and myself are Joyce Eladad and myself. We are both assistant professor at Paris Dauphine. This project is also done in cooperation with a Venezuelan researcher and of Universitat Simon Bolivar, the team of Judith Cardinal. And to include MED, we are not only women, and to have a bigger team, we just have recently submit an extension of our project to the Agence Nationale de la Recherche in order to have a little money because French researchers haven't money. So it includes other researchers of the LAMSAD and of other French university and school. And we have an industrial partner, which is a WebShell. So just to have a global view of what we do, we have a user, we ask a query, and we suppose that we need to give him a combination of services to answer his query. So he can ask his query with two different ways. He can give a workflow, which is a business process decomposed into activity. For example, he wants a flight ticket and I don't know, a room hotel reservation or a bed and breakfast reservation and so on. So he can ask his query with a workflow or either with only input and output attribute. He can give a name and keywords, and you want all the conferences with this person deal with this keyword on the conferences. So the user asks his query, and using the service registry, I will just explain you later how it is organized. We try to automatically define a service composition which answers the query. And this service composition has two particular properties. It's transactional. I will explain you in detail later, but it means that we ensure that all the component services will be executed or none of them. And it also, the resulting composite service also optimizes the quality of the service. So we suppose to have a service registry which contains service described with two kinds of properties. The quality of service properties, which can be the price we have to pay for invoke the service, the duration of the service, its reliability, and so on. So you can find, does it work? Yes, it works. You can find some of such quality of service value on a data set, yeah, this website, which contains a quality of values of extracted from real web service. This data set is really used by researchers to do their experiments. I give you a little example. If I ask, and I'm interested on a weather service, here this is the four first service returned by the data set, and you have for each service its response time and reliability. So each service is asked to be described by quality of service properties, and we also need transactional properties. This is this properties concerns a mechanism offered or developed by the providers, the service provider, to ensure a reliable execution of the service. So before explain you in detail what kind of what are these transactional property, I do a little parenthesis just to better understand after what are the transactional properties. So the a service execution has beginning and end. And if the failure occurs during the service execution, if the provider of the service developer propose mechanism to cancel or roll back the effect done by the service from its beginning until the failure, we call it backward recovery. If the provider offer mechanism to repair the failure and continue the execution of the service, we call it forward recovery. And we have another kind of recovery, which is called semantic recovery, which means that after the service execution, we can semantically undone the effect of the service. So the difference between the semantic recovery and the backward recovery is that the backward recovery occurs during the service execution, while the semantic recovery can be done after the service execution and is not always related to a failure. So to allow all these kind of recoveries, researchers have proposed different kind of transactional properties. In the slide, I present you the main use one by researcher. I give you here some references. So we have four transactional properties. The first one is called pivot. A service is pivot if once it's successful complete, effects remain forever, and it cannot be semantically undone. And in case of failure, it offers mechanisms to allow backward recovery. For example, a service we provide a flight ticket non-exchangeable and non-cancelable can be pivot. We have another property which is compensatable. For this services provider or service developer have developed another service or offer mechanism compensation policies to allow a semantic recovery, and in case of failure, as a pivot service, such service allow backward recovery. So for example, if here we can have a service providing flight ticket, which is can be cancelable, eventually with additive cost. And we have a third property, which is reliable. So it's a service which has a maximum guarantee of a successful termination. So generally, we use a replication mechanism to allow this kind of properties. And this properties is generally combined with the two previous ones. So we have pivot retrialap service, which then offer backward recovery and forward recovery, and a compensatable retrialable service, which offer backward, forward, and semantic recovery. So all the service we have are described by quality of service properties and transactional properties. And moreover, we have a specific organization of the service registry depending on how the user asks his query. So when he uses a workflow, so a business process decomposed into activity, for each activity, we need a class of service having a similar functionality. So we organized, in this case, the class of service by group of services having the similar functionality. We have a class of weather service, a class of service sending email, and so on. So in this case, to compose a service means that we have to select for each activity one service per class. And if the user asks his query only given input and output attributes, there we represent the service registry by graph. Each vertice, all the vertices of the graph are the service, and you have an edge between two services. You have an edge between a service A and a service B if the output provided by service A are input of the service B. And then, in this case, a service composition consists of of selecting several paths in the graph from the service which inputs are the user inputs to the service producing the user output. So this is the hypothesis of our approach. We use such a described service and organized service. And what we do is from the user query and the user registry, we offer mechanisms to automatically discover a composite service that correspond to the user query and which has two more properties, which is the composition is reliable, so we ensure that all the components will be executed on none of them. So for doing that, I have not the time, but we have defined some specific rule or mechanism to ensure that we select the service with the appropriate transactional property. So just for give you an idea, if I just look at this sub workflow, considering that we have two activities which can be executed in parallel, if for the top activity I select a pivot service because it can fail, I have to, for the bottom service, select a service which is compensatable, because if the first one fail, I have to compensate the second one if it has been executed. And at the same time, because the first one is pivot, it cannot be semantically undone. So for the second one, I should select a service which has a maximum guarantee of correct execution, so which is retrievable. So the composition we automatically offer to the user is reliable, and moreover, we propose algorithms to optimize the quality of service. So using a heuristic approach, we offer a local optimum, which means that for each, if you use a workflow for each activity, we select the best services having the minimum price of the best reliability of a combination of different criteria. And using an operational research approach like linear programming, we offer a global optimization. So this is for the phase of selecting. Then after having selecting all the components of the composition, we also have proposed approaches to allow a fault-tolerant mechanism execution. So we offer different case of fault-tolerant proposition. We have a mechanism that can substitute the failed service by another one, which guarantee a similar QoS, so allowing forward recovery. We also offer mechanisms to compensate the component which has been executed before the failure if we cannot substitute the failed component. And we also propose a mechanism that allow to restart the execution from a part of the composition which correspond to a reliable sub-execution of the service. So this is what we have done until now, and in the future, in our expanded project, we would like to consider the service selection from the service discovery to the service execution, and to take into account different kind of service, which can be SOAP service, RESTful one, data service based on database, and also linked service based on linked data. So it's our project is decomposed into three steps. So the first one concerns the service discovery. For the moment, we have the hypothesis that we have the service registry organized as we want, and so on. So we now try to find mechanisms to build this service registry. And to do that, we want to use approaches based on recommendation and also social network to see the service registry as a social network of services. The second step of our project concerns service selection. We have done always work on that, but we want to improve our algorithm and using operational research and also multi-criteria dimension for the moment to consider the quality of service. We just do a weighted sum of the different criteria, and we want to consider more precisely the different criteria of services. And in this case, we also use a service recommendation mechanisms. And to the service execution, we also want to improve our algorithm of fault tolerance control, also using operational research and recommendation-based proposal and using multi-criteria evaluation. And if you want to have a more general idea of what is done on research, I give you some references. The first two one are book chapter or books for non-researcher public, so easier to understand. And the third and fourth one could be a little bit difficult to understand in the first time. Thank you.
Oh, this one. So there will be the posters after, but we have time for one question about transactional web services. It's really state of the art. I know, Sam, that you are always state of the art.
Yeah, thanks for the talk. I actually read the paper, the first one, when I was a student, so it brings some old memories. But I was wondering, for example, how do you differentiate yourself from stuff like SCA? Component services, component architectures, and if you see if there is some industrial application of your work so far?
There will be one with Web Shell. In fact, researchers often work very far away from the industrial part, which is a pity. And we do simulation, and because we work on problem you don't. You will have in the future. So with Web Shell, we will apply our approach on concrete real application problem, yeah.
Okay, and I was wondering, this thing that used to be called software component architectures,
yeah.
It's SCA, one of the application is embedded in the Eclipse project, and it looks a little bit like this one. I don't know if you have, if there is any convergence with this kind of tooling, for example, your workflow engine, for example, where you want to compose the graph of services, there's these things called BPL and business process. I forgot how it's called, but you have this embedded in Eclipse, for example. So I don't know if you have seen, if you have any framework that's usable today, for example.
No, for the moment we use some approaches based on business process, but we not.
Okay, thank you.
Sorry.
Another question.
I couldn't help hearing the last bit of your talk there. The social media aspect of service registry, you know that one there. Is that an easier way of using UDDI?
In fact, we view all service composition as a social network, and there is many researcher work based on how analyze and understand social network, and we try to apply this kind of research on service composition. Did I answer your question? Or?
I was more specific on whether it makes it easier to deal with UDDI, because that's, although it's an aspirational thing, I find that a lot of people tend to build their own registries and repositories.
So I didn't understand.
Not to worry, thanks.
Okay, sorry.
I have a last question, just to say to a number, you know, about service composition, you know, Siri, you know, Google Now, maybe the next one from Samsung, which is Sami, they just announced it a few weeks ago. So it's just 50 to 70 service. Just a mode, with how many service you work your models?
We have some experiment using 20 or 40,000 of services.
Yeah, so we're really in a
It future. Works, but it's a simulation. So.
Yeah, simulation, but we are really preparing the future of software there. So thank you, Maud.
Thank you.